can have this feeling anytime you choose.
Hello there, and welcome back to Utopia. So you're finally ready to start working in Germany, and now you are wondering what kind of hospital you should work in and how does the system work and how do you apply. So today I'm going to explain you how the residency system works, how do you have to apply for the different hospitals, and which hospital is the best choice for you. Okay, but how does the system actually work? In some countries, like the United States or like in Spain, there is a national exam. And based on your score in the national exam, you get a point, you get in a list, and at the end, the very best get to choose the best positions and the very last don't get to choose anything. Germany is completely different. In Germany, there is no such an exam. You just get your approval to work and you are ready to go. You just have to contact the department of the hospital where you want to work and send them an email. If you already know in which hospital you want to work, it's a no-brainer. But if you don't, you can just click in Google Maps and find the hospital, look for its webpage, find the department in which you want to work, and find the contact in that department. It's very easy actually, and most hospitals have a very clear webpage with email and phone number that you can contact at any time. Then you just send them an email. And it is very important that you add three things to your email. First of all, you need to add your CV, then a motivational letter, and at the end, your diploma and approbación. But although this system seems to be easier and more fair since you get to apply to any hospital you want and you get the same chances as everyone else, it works a bit against us, the immigrants. Say that you want to be a cardiologist in Berlin, so you apply to the main hospitals in Berlin. But since it's Berlin, everyone wants to be a cardiologist there, so everyone applies for the same position. And since the hospital doesn't have any logical meters on which to evaluate you, they don't know how good you are in comparison with other doctors, their decision is quite subjective, and it's likely that they will choose the German person because the German person studied in Germany and that's more trustworthy. But that is not necessarily a bad thing. Another consequence is that the small hospitals, they receive barely no applications. And as their doctors become older and older and they start retiring, there is a lot of weight on their shoulders because they still need to do duties. And the few doctors which are there have to do most of the duties. And they really, really need new doctors. And that is where we come in. If you apply for a small hospital, chances are that they will accept you right away, and not only they will accept you, but also they will want you to stay there, and they will want you to do duties. This means they will teach you as much as they can, and they will be as nice as possible to make sure you stay. So let's compare both options. When it comes to getting the position, the big hospital is going to be quite challenging. It's going to be difficult to find the position. And when it comes to the small hospital, it's going to be easy peasy. When it comes to learning in the big hospital, you will start learning, at least at the beginning, mostly theory. While in the small hospital, they will teach you as much as you want and as fast as you want. However, on the other side, the big hospital will have complicated cases, so you will also get to see some things that you would never see in a small hospital. When it comes to the money, there is no difference between them. Germany is regulated when it comes to the payment, and it pays almost the same. When it comes to specificity, the big hospitals tend to specify a lot, what means that if you were to stay always in the big hospital, you would be very good at doing some things and you will know nothing about others, which is exactly the opposite as small hospitals, where a doctor kind of has to know how to do everything at the same time. I personally started working in a small hospital in the department of anesthesia a couple of months ago. It's a very small hospital and every night only one doctor does the duty, unlike big hospitals where sometimes it's two or three at the same time. This means that in order for me to do a duty, I really need to know how to do everything. And because of that, in the last couple of months, they have been teaching me everything I wanted to learn. They have been teaching me everything about intubation, all of the types of local anesthesias, regional anesthesias, all of the theory, Everything that can be learned, everything that is necessary to do a duty, they have been teaching me non-stop. And I really profited a lot from it, since some techniques I've been learning how to do, I've been told that in a big hospital they don't teach them to you until you're in third or second or third year of the residency. So you really learn a lot in a small hospital. On the other side, I deal mostly with typical cases, and if there is any rare disease or any extremely complicated case, normally that patient is sent to the bigger hospital. So there is some theory that I might be missing. So what I would personally recommend is to start working in a small hospital at least for 1 or 2 years, and when you have all of the necessary skills and you know how to do almost everything, then make the jump, make the change, and go to a bigger place. And speaking of changes, how does this work in Germany? In some countries, once you pick the hospital, you need to stay there the whole 4 years until you are done. And if you want to change the hospital, then you have to start over from the first year. In Germany, it's not the case. You can change any hospital anytime you want, you don't lose years. And what about changing specialties? If I am doing inner medicine and I realize I don't like it and I want to do anesthesia, or I want to do intensive medicine, do I lose all of the years I've been doing if I make the change? The answer is no. You don't lose any years, so you can make the change whenever you want. That is why it's a very good idea to start in a small hospital doing something very general. Imagine you want to be a cardiologist, and to find a position in cardiology is going to be very challenging and very difficult. So one thing many people do in order to get the position through the back door is to start in a smaller hospital doing inner medicine for 1 to 2 years to learn all of the ground, all of the basics that not only has to do with cardiology but with the whole body. And once you know everything you need to know, make the jump into cardiology, already knowing a lot and being sure that they will take you, they will accept you in the bigger hospital because you already have all of the experience that you need and you don't even lose years. Anyway, this is everything for today. I hope the video is bringing some useful information, and we will see each other the next time. Bye bye.